Students, in the previous video, we recalled the concept learned in the previous class and completed question number 1. Today we are going to solve another question. So let's solve question number 2. Question number 2. Check whether the value given in the bracket is a solution to the given equation or not. Students, in this question, you have to check whether the given value of the equation to the left-hand side is equal to the value of the equation to the right-hand side. That is, left-hand side is equal to right-hand side. If both the sides' value is equal, then you have to write the given value is the solution of the given equation. And if not, then you have to write the given value is not the solution of the given equation. So now let's solve sum A. N plus 5 equals to 19, where n equals to 1. Students, on left hand side, n plus 5 is given, and on right hand side, 19 is given. Writing 1 in place of n and adding 5 to it, you would get 6. Since 6 is not equals to 19, that is, left hand side is not equal to right hand side. So you have to write n equals to 1 is not the solution of the given equation. Now sum B, 7n plus 5 equals to 19, where n equals to minus 2. On left hand side, 7n plus 5 is given, and on right hand side, 19 is given. Writing minus 2 in place of n and multiplying minus 2 with 7 and adding 5 to the product, you would get minus 14 plus 5 equals to minus 9. Since minus 9 is not equals to 19, so you have to n equals to minus 2 is not the solution of the given equation. Now, let's solve sum C. 7n plus 5 equals to 19, where n equals to 2. On left hand side, 7n plus 5 is given, and on right hand side, 19 is given. Writing 2 in place of n and multiplying 2 with 7 and adding 5 to the product, you would get 14 plus 5, which is equals to 19. Since 19 is equal to 19, so you have to write n equals to 2 is the solution of the given equation. Students, you have to solve sum B, E and F by yourself. Now, question number 3. Solve the following equations by trial and error method. Students, in this method, we make a guess of the solution of the equation. We calculate left hand side and right hand side of the given equation for different values of the variable, and the value of the variable which satisfies the equation, that is for which left hand side equals to right hand side, is the solution or root of the equation. So let's solve question number 3, sum number 1. 5p plus 2 equals to 17. Let us find the left hand side and right hand side of the given equation of some values of p and continue to give new values till left hand side is equal to right hand side. Writing 2 in place of p and multiplying 5 with 2 and adding 2, you would get 10 plus 2 equals to 12. Since 12 is not equals to 17, so p equals to 2 is not the solution of 5p plus 2 equals to 17. Now we have to take another value, say 3, as 2 is not the solution of the given equation. Writing 3 in place of p and multiplying 3 with 5 and adding 2, you would get 15 plus 2 equals to 17. Since 17 is equals to 17, so p equals to 3 is the solution of 5p plus 2 equals to 17. Now sum number 2, 3m minus 14 equals to 4. Let's take the value of m equals to 4. Writing 4 in place of m and multiplying 4 by 3 and subtracting 14, you would get 12 minus 14. Subtracting 14 from 12, you would get minus 2. Since minus 2 is not equals to 4, so m equals to 4 is not the solution of 3m minus 14 equals to 4. Now let's take another value of m, which is 5. Writing 5 in place of m and multiplying 5 by 3 and subtracting 14, you would get 15 minus 14. Subtracting 14 from 15, you would get 1. Since 1 is not equals to 4, so m equals to 5 is not the solution of 3m minus 14 equals to 4. Now let's take another value of m, which is 6. Writing 6 in place of m, multiplying 6 by 3 and subtracting 14, you would get 18 minus 14. Subtracting 14 from 18, you would get 4. Since 4 is equals to 4, that is left hand side equals to right hand side, so m equal to 6 is the solution or root of 3m minus 14 equals to 4.